After more than 2 months of Disney holding clips from Star vs. the Forces of Evil Season 3 hostage against us, they finally showed us some new footage. The trailer starts by parodying the In a World cliche that movie trailers used to have, with it transitioning into this beautiful clip.
I'll never let you go, my little burrito.
While they do force a burrito meme down our throats, everything else was very informative about this trailer. I do actually believe that the burrito has significance, but we'll get into that later. We got the confirmation that a lot of us have been looking for. The High Commission members are still alive. This includes Glosseric. Or does it? Who some fans believe died in battle for Muni. Moon is also present, which destroys most of the Moon's death theories. Unfortunately, Lekmet is absent, and I think it's safe to assume that he's still dead. Throughout the trailer, it's clear that Star still has very little control over her wand, despite Toffee's death and the end of the Fritz. This could be because she's using a newer version of the wand, which could be too powerful for her to use. She's seen shooting at Romulus with it, as well as a Royal Guard member, which was most likely an accident. This is probably an excuse for more training episodes, but we'll take what we can get. Anyway, let's get back to the burrito. After some thought, what first seemed like a funny meme could be a feeling outlet. If you're confused, do not fear. You'll get your explanation, but first, let's start with the basics of this theory. So, you can easily notice the star might not be on Muni in this scene. It looks a lot like her old room on Earth. At least remotely resembles it. Now, we are not sure what happened to Marco and Jackie's relationship, but they are definitely still together. Now, I don't doubt Marco isn't concerned of Star's emotions, but I don't think his emotions for Jackie would just disappear. So while he is outside, possibly on a date with her, or just to give her an explanation on all the recent events, Star is left alone. The burrito on her face could be her way of coping with the negative emotions and trying to move on. There is no one who she is playing the board game with as well, so she could be trying to suppress her feelings and find a painless way to get rid of her crush. We also see a scene of Ponyhead all dolled up. She could have been the one that Star was talking to, inviting her for a girl's day out and help her get better in Ponyhead style, which then takes us to the next crucial theory. There are a few scenes where we can see Star fighting, and Ponyhead is there with her as well. Now, there are a few theories I can think of. Perhaps St. Olga's is taken over by Heinous again, and Star is helping Ponyhead get a hold of it again. But then again, the background shows that they are definitely in a place that looks nothing like St. Olga's. Well, we are aware that King Ponyhead doesn't trust his daughter so much. Maybe Star and Ponyhead are taking over the throne of the Ponyhead Kingdom? But that just doesn't seem right now, does it? So then what? Well, here's where we get to the juicy stuff. Star attacking the guard made me think that someone took over Muni Kingdom, and now her BFF on Muni is one of the allies helping her get it back, which would explain her gathering her friends throughout the intro. And now, yes, you could say she's training or to retrieve the hoodie, but there are a few factors I believe otherwise. One of them is that there are pipes all around the place in the scene where she is attacking the guard. Another one is also her expressions when blasting and in the countless scenes. And the fact Eclipse is crystal cracked at the end of Battle for Muni, and the entrance to the guard ran to was shaped like Eclipse's cheek marks. But those are all small hints. The bigger one is in this one little detail. Notice something? They are all in the fighting stance. They are heading to battle, and for what? He's not dead, but neither is he alive. Just like the High Commission was he, is tied to Star's ankle, floating like a balloon. They are most likely fighting to get through the fountain room to revive him. And with him being revived, the book could get revived as well, as he is directly connected to it. I don't believe whoever took over Muni would want someone of Star's caliber to get a hold of it, especially now with her growing in her seriousness and her magic getting stronger. With a mentor, she could go far. I believe that all of these small clips actually resemble the whole story. That will start with something small to leave us all with our minds blown away. Anyway, that was for the big guns, but let's not forget to mention some of the smaller gems or some other theories. Ponyhead being all dolled up, later we said was her getting Star relaxed because of her love problems. But what if it's a scene of her at the Silver Bell Ball? Now that could take the story to a different turn. Also, even without Glosseric, Star doesn't cease to surprise us. her creative mind keeps coming up with new amazing spells. Like the arm, though, of course, she would use it to get the chips off the floor into her mouth. Star, you can have all the character development, but you're still our lazy princess. But now let's talk about the real reason we are so excited over the promo. We finally get to see Marco in his glorious cape. Now that is what you call awesome with the plus 50% of cute. And some scenes just look so beautiful not to be mentioned. However, that's all we have for today. I hope you enjoyed this video and all these theories. Hope you leave yours down in the comments,